Good day, friends. Today's subject is the 7th King Donald Trump and the 8th King Barack Obama. Now, there are many that state several things to me. They say, yes, we cannot know the Antichrist. They say what I'm writing is too extreme. They cannot post it on their or share it on their websites. And that is possibly the reason why the view count is so low. But I completely refute that. That statement is completely untrue. What you're saying, we cannot know the Antichrist. Yes, we may know who the Antichrist is. They are here already. They are functioning. They are alive and are very well. They are here on the earth. And they are in the president of the White House, and now there's the next president in as well. Yeah, it says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. The fall away is here. The apostasy is here. The false gospel preaching is here, and you cannot say that this is untrue. It can. Some say it comes after the rapture. No, sir. It is before the rapture. The falling away first, the revealing of the Antichrist, and only then, when the restrainer is removed, then they can come to power, but they already revealed. In fact, they already hinted who they are. Both of these men, the Bible, Daniel, and the book of Revelation, describe these two men to the letter T. The description, Donald Trump is stout. Daniel 7, he is more stout than his predecessors, than his fellow, than his fellows. It fits Donald Trump. It fits him to the T. Both of these men speak big things. I will make America great again, as well as Obama. They spoke against the things of God. So, yeah, Donald Trump is the 7th king and Barack Obama is the 8th king. Donald Trump is the Jewish Messiah. The Jews will not receive somebody else like Obama. And or the Pope for the matter. The Pope is not the false prophet, people. Not the false prophet at all. Many of you say, no, it cannot be from America. It must be from Europe. America, people, America, the United States is the new Rome, stated by Netanyahu himself. America is the key player in creating the new world order that will put the false prophet and the Antichrist into power. They both come from the USA. They must have the training in the strongest military, people. They will both be military experts when they come on the scene. And that is why they need to have the training in the greatest nation of the earth, which is the United States of America. Okay? Barack Obama is the Mahdi. He is the 8th king. He is also of the 7th. Let me read that scripture for you quickly. Now the religious, sorry, not the political Babylon, which is the religious Babylon. Here is the mind that has wisdom. The 7 heads are 7 mountains on which the womb. There are 7 kings, 5 are fallen, the one is, the other has not yet come. When he comes, he must continue a little while, a short space of time. And that short space of time is 3.5 years. The beast that was and is not is himself also an 8 and is all the 7th, and he goes into destruction. The 10 horns that you saw are 10 kings who have received no kingdom as yet, but they receive authority as kings with the beast for 1 hour. And what you actually see here is the map down below. Revelation 13 deals with the New World Order. That is the New World Order. And Donald Trump will be the seventh king, the leader of the New World Order. But now you ask me, what about Barack Obama? Barack Obama rules the last 3.5 years of the tribulation, which is also 3.5 years. But he is on the scene, and he sits in the UN, and both of them are related to 666, by the way, because they have the same power. Donald Trump is the first beast. Donald Trump is the second beast of Revelation 13. Barack Obama is the first beast of Revelation 13. The Revelation 13 deals with a new world order, as I say. Yes, the first beast is called the Antichrist, but the Bible calls him the first beast. And the second beast is called the false prophet. The false prophet is not the Pope. You can put your head on a block. It's not the Pope. The Jews will not receive the Pope at all. So Donald Trump is the Jewish Messiah. So he is the seventh king. He is, as I said, he's the second beast of Revelation 13. And he will rule and reign once America is destroyed. And there are some that says he will a second term. I don't think there will be elections, because the sixth seal will happen before the elections comes. That's it, people. 2020 is the time, friend, that Jesus will come and the tribulation is going to start. And let me also tell you, he is the little horn that Donald Trump. He is the little horn of Daniel 7. Barack Obama is the little horn of Daniel 8. See my previous post. Yeah, so he will rule the first 3.5 years as a New World Order leader. And Donald Trump, he will be raised from the dead. The beast has been described in Revelation 13:11, and another beast rise up from the earth. It speaks of a resurrection. Barack Obama, he will have a wound, and that comes towards the middle of the tribulation, the last part of the tribulation. And Barack Obama will ruin, he will sit in the temple of God as God. That is what's going to happen. But then Donald Trump will be next to him. Donald Trump is actually the spokesman for the Antichrist. Donald Trump is the anti-spirit. Barack Obama is the Antichrist. I hope you do understand that well. And the last portion where it says the 10 kings that you saw are 10 kings who have received no kingdom as yet, but they receive authority as kings with a beast for 1 hour. This is the last part here. You can see the map of the world here. The seven heads are the seven continents that are divided into 10 regions, and 10 kings will find power within 1 hour. 1 hour with the beast. With the beast. It doesn't say which beast it is, but it's with Donald Trump. Donald Trump is with the beast, so it could be with any beast, you know. So He is of the eight. He is of the seven, but he is also of the eight. Meaning, what does that mean? Means Barack Obama is of the New World Order, the seventh, but he is also the eighth, and he is the last king, the last world.
Let us just quickly return to that scripture in Revelation 17. Revelation 17:9. It's a year. Is the mind that has wisdom. The seven heads are seven mountains. It speaks of seven kingdoms, previous kingdoms, on which the woman sits. Remember I said it's got to do with religious Babylon. Now there are seven kings, five has fallen. What does that mean? Five has fallen, it speaks of the past. The one is the other has not yet come, which he comes, he must continue a little while. Just let us pause there for a while. Now, the angel said to John, here is wisdom, use wisdom. Now, we're speaking about our generation. And this Revelation 17 got to do with our generation. It says that seven kings, five have fallen. Now, we all know there are 64 kings, presidents in America, but we got, speaking of the last seven in our generation, from the time they tried to divide it, the land of Israel. Now, they are Jimmy Carter, they are Reagan, Bushenia, Clinton, that is, of course, that is 4-4, yeah, that is Clinton, Bush Jr., that is 5, Barack Obama, 6, and then Donald Trump. Remember, he was in, his inauguration was 2017, so he is in power now. So he is the seventh king. And I believe he will be the last president of the United States of America. Yes. And if you look into the past, there were seven kingdoms. They were Egypt, ruled by the pharaohs. There were Assyria, number two. There were Babylon, ruled by Nebuchadnezzar, that is 3, the Medes and the Persians, ruled by the first king that was Cyrus there, and then 5th, it was the Grecian Empire by Alexander Great, and of course we know that he died and his generals ruled, and out of that came the little horn, and that was Antiochus Epiphanes. And Barack Obama here is 69 times removed from Antiochus Epiphanes, and I believe he will continue then in the last kingdom, the eighth king. Yeah. So that is what I believe, and that is my interpretation there. The beast that was and is not. Now, in Revelation, they say, well, they wander out of the beast. Now, scholars say that is ancient Babylon returning. Can it be ancient Babylon returning? The people will not wander after a beast. That was ancient times. They have no idea. But here comes Barack Obama. He has been president of the United States. And here he come on the scene. And the people wonder. And of course, he have a wound. Barack Obama have been wounded, injured badly. And I believe he will just have one eye. And yeah, and as I said previously, Donald Trump, he will have a resurrection. And that is also what the Jews do believe. They believe Ben Joseph, which is Donald Trump, the second beast of Revelation 13, he will arise from the dead. So there you have it, and following it will be Egypt. It will be Assyria, it will be Babylon, it will be the Medes and the Persians, in follow, it will be then Alexander the Great, the first, and then Rome 6, and then the seventh kingdom, which is the New World Order kingdom, will be ruled by Donald Trump, and the last one, the eighth kingdom, which is the eighth king, which is Donald Trump, and they all just all both of them have a rule of 3.5 years. He will make away with the New World Order, and he will have the Antichrist government from Jerusalem, of course. These two fit the best description according to Daniel and the book of Revelation. Okay, so as you see this, they find, how are they going to rule the world? They're going to divide the world into 10 regions, and 10 kings will find power within 1 hour with the Antichrist. So there you have it. Be blessed. Thanks for your prayer, and thanks for those who give towards this ministry. I appreciate every donation, and please do subscribe and press the notification button. But please do like the video, and please do share the video. It's not extreme. It's not extreme at all, or too high above your knowledge. We see the things happening before us. So please do share it. Jesus is, it's important to Jesus. He wants us to know who these people are, so that we can save as many as souls as possible during the tribulation. God bless people.